today. From AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. This is Madden NFL 21. We'll see Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys taking on Baker Mayfield and the Cleveland Browns.
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. A moment ago, here was the scene with the Cowboys emerging from their tunnel. It was loud. It's still loud. We're ready for football as the Cowboys get set to match up with the Cleveland Browns. Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Here's the Cleveland offense, and here's Baker Mayfield, former Heisman Trophy winner, ready to go at quarterback.
And I think Baker Mayfield has had a tremendous offseason getting ready for this one because he put the focus squarely on football and cut out a lot of the peripheral stuff. Just focused in on being the best quarterback and leader for his Cleveland Browns team, and now all he has to do, take care of the turnover issues of last year. 21 interceptions he threw, second most in the NFL.
First carry for Nick Chubb. Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Now Mayfield. And it's hauled in by Austin Hooper. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a gain in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that opens things up for you on the outside as well.
But that's where he, their big tight end, is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the end routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well, and he's got it.
And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete. So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. And now Mayfield on the bootleg. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. Looked like man coverage, able to read it there on the outside for the completion. That'll be something to track as the game goes along here.
It certainly will, and there's so many different ways that they will try to figure out whether they're in man or zone. Sometimes they'll run a guy in motion to see if someone runs with him. Other times they'll empty out the backfield, spread it out, and see if everyone comes out and matches up. In any event, anytime you see man coverage, you tell your guys you've got to win those matchups, because if you do, you'll get the football and probably for a nice game.
And a nice carry and a first down for Cleveland. A nice pickup there by Nick Chubb, who's a bright spot for this Cleveland offense. He finished second in the league in rushing in 2019 with nearly 1,500 yards on the ground. and got into the end zone 8 times. And how about this for durability? Has not missed a game in his NFL career. What a bounce back from a big-time knee injury while at the University of Georgia.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. Mayfield looks to throw. And he gets it to his running back, Nick Chubb. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, 3rd and 5. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
This Cowboy defense looked ready for that 3rd down pass. Brings up 4th.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker roll that they can fall back on anymore.
Now Cody Parkey out to try the field goal. From the right hash, it's a 46-yard attempt. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And the Browns are out to a 3-0 lead. So the opening drive does yield points. Maybe not the 7 they wanted, but they'll take the 3.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the 3.
Yeah, they had 3 first downs and 3 points. Parkey now following the made field goal to kick this one off. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. First look at the Cowboys offense as Dak Prescott gets ready to guide them.
You hear so many discussions about Dak Prescott. Is he one of the top quarterbacks in the league? Is he still ascending? What does he need to do to get there? All I know is that when he's in control of the Dallas offense, they were number 1 in the league last year in terms of yards per play. And he was 2nd in the league in passing yards with over 4,900. This guy gets it done, and his team really likes him as their leader.
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a 1st and 10, just shy of the 30. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 11 yards there, 1st down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
He'll fire this deep for Gallup, and it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Michael Gallup, that's who he was looking for. That'll bring up 2nd down.
And there shouldn't be any surprise at all when we watch him flash his arm. Easy motion, easy action, and that ball flies downfield.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. He finds his target, it's Schultz. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead. The The last catch did get three, but they're still left needing 7 yards on third down. Prescott yet again. And he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns' 41-yard line. A Cowboy first down there. Prescott to Gallup. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 41. And again, it's Prescott. Over the middle, complete. It's Schultz. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down.
For many teams, the evaluation of tight ends has really changed. We used to wonder about how they would block first and foremost. Now we want to know how these guys can run, because we envision them in offenses, catch the ball. How much yardage can they gain after that?
And that on display there for a good pickup. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. The give is to Elliott. And he'll get four there, down to about the 12-yard line. And now timeout is whistled as it appears there's a Brown shaken up on the play. We'll check on his status when we get back. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. The rookie CeeDee Lamb, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
So it's third and six, and this will be the eighth play of the drive. Prescott from the gun. And this is caught. It's Cooper. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the five at the four. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that would be pinpoint here.
I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
Looking to throw, Prescott. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the seven. The D-tackle, Sheldon Richardson, came barreling in for the sack.
On any first and goal, the real estate to work with for the offense is really cut down, and the defense knows it. So they often bring heat and pressure, which they did on this play. Got him down for a loss, not a big one, but any loss of yardage in this position is tough for an offense.
Now from the seven, here's second and goal. Again to Elliott, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Taking it in from 7 yards away, and the Cowboys have taken the lead. People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that, and wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. A pretty long drive that time, 11 plays all told. And it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. The Cleveland Browns getting the football back, and CeeDee, the Browns are over 500, 2-1 on the season, the first time since 2014 that they have been over the 500 mark. Hard to believe, and that includes just being 1-0, because that hasn't happened yet, but now with the wins in weeks 2 and 3, they are there.
And how about this team? Baker Mayfield, he and his team had a rough opener against Baltimore. They got beat 38-6. Well, he's bounced back well. He had 2 touchdown passes in this game. Nick Chubb added 2 on the ground. Kareem Hunt's running the football. Kind of reminds you a little bit of that great 80s duo in Ernest Biner and Kevin Mack in the backfield. Can they recreate that? They're doing their best to do that. The defense, 5 takeaways against Washington. Picked up Dwayne Haskins 3 times. I think it's a good roster. Even though I saw them in the opener against Baltimore, I still thought it was a good roster. Baltimore's just awfully good, as we well know. Now they got 3 really tough games coming up. At Dallas, who needs the win in a big way. Home against Indy, who seems to have righted their ship. And then they're at Pittsburgh, who is currently undefeated.
To the right side, and he's got Landry complete. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down.
There's Jarvis Landry with the nice reception and pickup there. And when you say Pro Bowl, you better think Jarvis Landry. He's been selected to it every year since 2015. The only season he's missed is rookie year. And he is durable and tough. We talk about that all the time. How about this for an example? Hasn't missed a game in his first 6 seasons and was a 1,000-yard receiver for the 3rd time in 2019.
They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
Well, we use the term pitch and catch a lot to denote an easy completion. We just saw one right there on 3rd and 3 to pick up the 1st down.
Why are those so tough to defend? Just because they hit so quickly?
Yeah, it's all about timing and confidence. Quarterback sees it, rips it. There you go.
A 1st down throw for Mayfield. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Landry. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down. Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Mayfield with it once more. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. No gain on that one, and it's going to bring up a 3rd down.
I know that play went for no yardage, all right? But I like the attempt, because the fullback position, whether it's a fullback, a tight end, an H-back, whoever you want in that spot, not known as a primary pass catcher. So sometimes the element of surprise works in your favor. But on that play, give credit to the defensive guys.
And he's got the 1st down before being taken down at the 46. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
I haven't met a football team yet that runs the ball successfully that doesn't talk about having an attitude to be a running football team, right? You got to be able to put your nose in there, smell where the 1st down sticks are, and get there.
First down, they go right back to Hunt. And he's going to be met at about the 43. A minimal gain as we tick down inside of a minute remaining in the opening quarter. On 2nd and 7, Mayfield looking left side. That's caught by Landry. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
This will be play number 8 here on the drive. It's 3rd and 1 yard. They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They go play action. Mayfield. This will be caught inside the 10. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
And there's a good catch by Odell Beckham Jr. And in 2019, even though it was one of the least productive seasons of his career, he was still a 1,000-yard receiver for the fifth time. Also caught the longest reception of his career as well, an 89-yard touchdown against the Jets on a Monday night. Explosive is Odell Beckham Jr.
They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. A gain of six there on first.
And there's a completion to Austin Hooper. What a big-time acquisition for this offense in Cleveland. Came from Atlanta as a two-time Pro Bowler. Had nearly 800 yards in receptions and six touchdowns last year. And he spends a lot of time with his quarterback in order for them to get on the same page on every snap.
And that's going to be caught for a Browns touchdown. Harrison Bryant there to make the grab. And once again, the Browns are back in front.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run and he finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
Cody Parkey is on now for the point after. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. That one in the books as a 12-play drive. And it ends with a touchdown for Cleveland. Now after the score, it's Parkey on to kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Well, the Dallas Cowboys, Charles, boy, they have been nothing if not entertaining in 2020. Some wild games early. Another one in week three at Seattle. The bottom line, they fall to 1-2 on the year after a 38-31 defeat at the hands of the Seahawks. But Dak Prescott continues to throw the ball all over the yard, make it 922 yards passing in the last 2 weeks. The 450 against the Falcons in that come-from-behind win. He threw another 472 against the Seahawks, just the second guy to throw for over 450 in back-to-back games. The other was Jameis Winston.
And can you believe he's putting up those kind of numbers? Because don't we think of Dallas as being led by Ezekiel Elliott in the running game? They've struggled to have consistency there, and the offensive line is not what it was a couple of seasons ago. They've got some guys filling in for some injured players right now. So Dak, they're relying on his right arm. Fortunately for the Cowboys, this schedule that's been kind of wild in the beginning, it settles down a little bit. Three home games coming up to start the month of October. Cleveland, the Giants, and Arizona. They've got a chance to get right in those three games.
The throw over the middle taken in, and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. He's going to find Gallup here complete and taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Another connection between the two. This one good for 12 and a first down. So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 43. This is Elliott. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Second and 7. Here's Prescott to the left side and complete for Amari Cooper. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns 23. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
It's funny when I go back to our pregame meeting with Amari Cooper and we mentioned, what if they play man coverage against you? He almost seemed offended by it, didn't he?
I'll beat it. That's basically what he said, right?
I mean, the best receivers we've ever talked to and covered, when you talk about covering them with one guy, they think that's a personal affront. If they feel like if they can't just beat one defender, then they're not very good.
Coming to you. Check, 93's the mic, 93's the mic. Right here.
Prescott on first down. And he's got it. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Cowboys have once again taken the lead.
As a general rule, quarterbacks don't want to lock in on a receiver before the ball is snapped. But in this case, based on the matchup he thought he was going to get, it was favorable for his tight end. He locked in on him early and found him for a touchdown.
Now Zuerlein on to add the extra point. And that makes it 14-10. That time a 6-play drive. And it's capped off for the Cowboys touchdown. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Here comes Johnson on the return. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30.
I'm ready to take over, baby. Stand up.
Now Nick Chubb of the Browns gets set for their next possession. Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Out of the gun, he'll throw. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Jarvis Landry, Pro Bowl wideout, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. Switching gears, CeeDee, one thing that I saw on social media this week that we need to pass along, if we can switch sports for just a minute, LeBron James has got the L.A. Lakers into the NBA Finals, of course. It'll be his 10th ever appearance, and they'll be taking on the Miami Heat. But what caught my attention was a post of LeBron's on social media of what he does every night while in the Orlando bubble. He settles down with a nice refreshing beverage and fires up a game of Madden. So we had to give him a shout out and wish him good luck.
Hey, good luck to LeBron and the Lakers. What a great final taking on the Miami Heat. So he and AD taking on Jimmy Butler, Tyler Hero, what they call it, buckets. What a great NBA final. Hope you guys have a blast, and LeBron, keep playing. We love it.
And he stopped up short of the first as they tackle him down at about the 36. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. On fourth down, here's Jamie Gillen on to punt. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Amari Cooper and the Cowboys set to take over once again. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. And he'll throw right away. And the Browns pressure gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. Larry Ogunjobi busting through to get him for a loss of 6. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Prescott to throw it. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Schultz. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. It just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
For Prescott. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure, when you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And the Browns will take over, first and 10. The Browns set to take over. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
To begin the drive, here's a handoff to Hunt. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all, challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. Here's Hunt. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
From just shy of midfield, Mayfield. Flush to his right. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain.
Certainly making his presence felt in both the pass and the run game. He's having an impact.
Yeah, his first carry of the game right there. He had hurt him with his arm. Now he's showing that he can shuffle the puppies as well. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They'll try to throw here, Mayfield. And his throw's gonna be incomplete. Rashard Higgins was the one he was looking for, but it's gonna be second down. And that one gonna be off target and incomplete. Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb, and he struggles to get a yard here, maybe a yard, down to the 31.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
The Browns on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. From the gun, Mayfield. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And they will rally and stop him short of the first down. They get him to the ground at the 26.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report, but business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coach's 2-minute drill.
No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
Parkey now following the made field goal to kick this one off. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Dak and the Cowboy offense heading back onto the field. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes, but right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. Prescott looks to throw on first. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
Well, Charles, on a different topic, a neat story from week three and that game between Washington and Cleveland. It was a history-making game in one respect. It was the first time in league history that you had women working on both coaching staffs, Jennifer King of Washington, Callie Brownson of Cleveland, as well as another woman, Sarah Thomas, working on the officiating crew.
Yeah, Ron Rivera, the head coach of the Washington football team, he said all we're doing is just creating opportunities for people who deserve it. And I know his counterpart, Kevin Stefanski in Cleveland, felt the same way. Quick facts on these people. Callie Brownson, Jennifer King, both got their starts at Dartmouth under Buddy Tevens, the head coach there. Sarah Thomas has already worked an NFL playoff game. So not only are they getting opportunities, they're running with them.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end complete. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time and another first down.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. If you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. From the red zone now, Prescott. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. CeeDee Lamb is intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
Well, that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll throw again. Prescott to the end zone, but it's incomplete. This drive, which was going so smoothly, all of a sudden it's a little bit of a roadblock here with two straight incompletions.
Yeah, apparently this defense has had enough. Apparently they're saying, no more. We're making a stand right here, right now. But it is third and 10. They've got to get after him one more time.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. Able to hit his target, Lamb. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. Cowboys trot out Greg Zuerlein. Zuerlein's kick is up and through. And that'll move their lead up to four now. So the scoring drive encompasses nine plays, and the net result, 3 points.
Take your disappointment and put it aside. Nine plays, yeah, they want to end up in the end zone with a touchdown. I get that. But sometimes those nine-play drives pay dividends later with another nine-play drive that culminates in a touchdown when they wear down a defense.
half of the made field goal. Zuerlein back out there now to send this one away.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Baker Mayfield leads the offense out for their next possession. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but bottom line, his team's losing. They got to fix something.
And it starts with him. He has to keep that little quarterback strut going right now to make sure that his team sees him as confident. Continue to try and up his game, but just let them know, hey, if I'm around, if I'm the one calling signals and throwing the football, just follow me, we'll get there. Sometimes that will do more to elevate a team than anything else.
See if he has that confidence. They'll go screen here to Hunt. A nice little screen. They get six on first down. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. Final play of the half, Mayfield over the middle, and it's incomplete. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. We were treated to a fine first half from Dak Prescott. He's thrown for close to 200 yards already, and that's helped propel his guys into the lead as we send you back to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Let's see what our player spotlight feature has in store with Dak Prescott. He's had one of those games that any quarterback loves, not only being able to complete some passes, but some deep passes.
And it's pretty to watch. I mean, it's an absolute joy to see, but let's face it, we got to give a little bit of credit where it's deserved, right?
Well, the protection's been great, if that's where you're going.
Yeah, protection's been phenomenal, but how about how it's been spotlighted, right? Our producer, Christian McLeod, our director, Kyle Burt, the rest of the crew, what they put together with these images and pictures, if you're an offensive lineman, that's what you're taking with you to contract time.
They're going to have a lot to take to contract time if this continues. Second half starts with a carry by Elliott, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Again, it's Elliott. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
A first down carry by Elliott. B.J. Goodson there on the tackle.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Now a second down and six. 10th carry now for Elliott. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds. So a big call there that brings up fourth. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
Here's the Browns now. They get set for their first possession of the third quarter. Their defense just came up with a stop right out of the locker room, and now can the offense take advantage?
Yeah, we don't want to turn this into something that it's not. It's only a one-score game, so it's not exactly a crucial possession. But at the same time, they'd like to get things started and at least come away with 3 points.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two, wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Running with Hunt here out of the shotgun. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for first.
Well, we always talk about good down and distance, allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
Back to the ground. This time it's Chubb. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Six yards left on second down. Mayfield looks to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. That catch good for 5. It's third down. And the Cowboys here on third down bringing in an extra defensive back. A give. This is Chubb. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
Two first downs have them up to the 41 now for first and 10. A run for Nick Chubb. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
And we're at the 41, second and 9. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. It's caught over the middle, Hooper. And he takes this down deep on the Cowboys' side of the field. A big play that time for Cleveland, 43 yards.
Oftentimes now, offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just tell receivers, find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air, nice chunk of yardage there, and then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And he's got his man on the crossing route, that's Landry. And he's gonna be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Options galore here, second and a few inches. Now they return to the ground game, Chubb. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. A 5 yard gain, and now they're set up first and goal.
Some good strong running right there, some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
Throw it. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. Let's go, baby. Let's go, baby. Mayfield finding Odell Beckham with a touchdown pass as his guys are able to regain the lead. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route, ordinarily it's probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. And that one gives him a 3-point lead. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive, and it's capped off by the Browns' touchdown. Now after the score, it's Parkey on to kick it away. This is Tony Pollard. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. The Dallas offense back out onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with a game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at the 33-yard line. He'll hand it off to Elliott to begin the drive. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call.
No!
So a holding penalty, and that'll send him backwards.
You know they're trying not to do that. I mean, we know that, right? We talk to them all the time. But sometimes the defensive guys just put you in awkward situations, and you get caught grabbing their jerseys.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Prescott from the gun. Sideline throw, that's caught. Amari Cooper. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for them. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
On third down, it's Prescott. Eluding the pressure right. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's fourth.
And they had an extra defensive back on the field on that play, and the coverage was excellent. He tried to pull it down and run for it, but they rallied to him and kept him short of a first down.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he's on to kick it away. The call for a fair catch, and it's made at about the 23-yard line. A 40-yard punt, no return, and out will come the offense as they take over. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, first and 10 at their own 23. He'll start things off with a handoff to Chubb, and they're able to get this one across the 35. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. Now Chubb. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
They went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Mayfield off the play fake. And that one incomplete. They try to sneak in a deep ball with the clock running down, but to no avail as time will expire on this third quarter of play. Back now in Arlington. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. The Browns on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is 3rd and 8. To throw, Mayfield. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down. Critical play in this football game because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them because they know that if they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
Here's Jamie Gillen now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. This is taken at the 15. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. He'll set up to throw from the gun. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Elliott. Not much there, only a yard. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. Throw left side, complete. That's Elliott.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense, because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
The Cowboys on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 68 yards receiving now for him in the game. And a first down on that last catch as well. What a throw right there for the first down. He has taken some real punishment in this game, but still standing in the pocket completing that one.
He's a flat-out warrior. There's no question about that. How about him stepping up into the teeth of the rush and delivering there for that big strike and that big pickup?
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. To the air again, Prescott. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up 2nd down.
I'll tell you, as a defender, you've got to make life as difficult as possible when you're trying to cover a big tight end, because you know his catch radius is huge. He's unable to pull that one in, though.
So after the incompletion on 1st, now 2nd and 10. And again, it's Prescott. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, 3rd down.
And now offensively, it's 3rd and 10, and I'm just thinking to myself, actors always say, what's my motivation before a big scene? Right now, the play caller's thinking, what have I done before that's worked well that I can go to right now?
Yeah, because they were pretty successful in the first half scoring points. Haven't done anything so far here in the second half. Now a shot taken on 3rd down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And they'll play keep away from the returner, as this one will be marked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Pretty good spot. Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. From the 13 now, they work on 1st and 10. They'll start with Hunt on the ground. And he takes us across the 15 to the 17.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
A tight game like this, such a tough spot for the offense to be in, even though they have the lead, Charles, back up so close to their goal line, they got to protect the football.
And that's when you have to take care of your team with play calling as well. Not a lot of misdirection, not a lot of counters, not a lot of plays where you have extra ball handling. Get it right to the hands of your running back, tell him to take care of the ball, and try to move forward.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Hunt, and he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
The Browns on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This will be third and five. Now Mayfield. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker.
Looking to throw on first down and finding the tight end Hooper. A gain of 6 there on first.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught and you don't give up much run after the catch.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Hand off comes to Chubb. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down.
And that's the type of run that they're looking for, because they'll need to continue to rely on him to move the sticks in this tight game in order to preserve this lead.
Two first downs have him up to the 41 now for first and 10. Throwing, Mayfield. Over the middle to Beckham. And he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out come the flags. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they're marching off another 15 against your squad.
The penalty moves him into the red zone here on first and 10. Following the penalty, Chubb. He'll get forward for 3 down to the 16-yard line. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
They go with Chubb on second down. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. A 16-yard touchdown run. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know that sounds really generic and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front, offensive line, collective victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
And his guys will take a 10-point lead. So this drive spans 7 plays. And Nick Chubb, the one to finish it off, as he does so with a touchdown run. Now after the score, it's Parkey on to kick it away. Now Pollard. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Dak and the Cowboys ready for their next possession.
So, Charles, there are the numbers. What's happened here? Defensive adjustments that's caused him to sort of fall off a bit?
I think so. That has to happen. You've got to make some changes because in the first half, they were pretty effective. But the second part is sometimes when you're doing really well, you get off your game a little bit. You get off the gas a little. You're like, okay, we've got this thing. And that's not necessarily the case. Maybe right now, someone just needs to tell a joke in the huddle, loosen things up, and get their big guy going again.
Now a throw over the middle, and he's got it to start the drive. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
On first and 10, Prescott. He finds his target. It's Schultz. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9.
And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. A gain of 13. It's a first down. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. CeeDee Lamb is intended target, but it'll be second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Prescott yet again. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
The Cowboys on third down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This is third and 10. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And that is incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Desperation time. Prescott on fourth. Looking deep in the direction. And this is taken in at the 5. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Now Elliott, and he will fight his way into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, his second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Cowboys draw a bit closer.
Nice job of polishing off that drive, but all the credit there goes to that play prior.
Yeah, it certainly does, because after that big play, I think resistance almost felt futile at that point, didn't it? And the very next play, they come right back, quick, fast, and in a hurry, and put it in the end zone.
Zuerlein now for the PAT. And the lead is down to a field goal now. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away.
And this will make it into the end zone. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. Ready to take over again on offense. Out comes Cleveland. Their lead back down to 1 score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here 1st and 10.
Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll begin the drive with Hunt. And some room to roam now. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. From the gun, Mayfield. Caught left side, it's Beckham. And he will be out of bounds. A good yardage there, and he'll get a second to catch his breath as it leads us right into the 2-minute warning. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a 1st and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. On 1st down, they'll run with Chubb. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, 2nd and 10. And again, it's Chubb. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. And on 3rd down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. Mayfield leaves it for Hunt on the draw. And he'll be brought down at the 34, well short of the 1st down marker. The Cowboys signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. And this one is right down Broadway. And that will double their lead as it's up to 6. So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they'd feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down.
Parker Parkey now following the made field goal to kick this one off.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
So Dak and the Cowboys down by six, a minute 40 remaining. They need a touchdown. A field goal is worthless now as they come up on first and 10. Joby in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
Amari Cooper, his intended receiver, but now it'll be third down. Tried to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Larry Ogunjobi able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon. So down six, and they know they need this one on fourth down. Now Prescott. And that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. So that one hurt. No timeouts left. Look at where the ball is on the field, Charles. I don't know if the fat lady's singing yet, but she's starting to hum a little bit, isn't she?
You think she's doing scales at this point? I don't think there's any doubt about it, but they had to go for it. In this situation, with their timeout situation as well, they had to take the chance, try and get it done. They didn't. Now they're powerless to stop them, essentially.
They need a big play somehow from their defense. Down to one knee goes Mayfield, and that's all she wrote.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world, and get it done, how happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something, and they did in this one. So Cleveland able to come away with the victory here. And you look back over the score sheet, interesting. A very clean game, no turnovers by either side.
An absolute rarity when we watch games now because defenses have put such an emphasis on taking the ball away. Well, what we saw here was offenses spending their time saying, look, you know they're coming for it. Ball security is paramount. So they worked on that, not just a week of practice, but I'm sure all during training camp. Make sure when you have it, tuck it away because danger lurks everywhere you turn.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we say so long from Big D.